Hello, everybody. It's Bourbon Bill, and tonight, a very special episode. You might wonder why I'm dressed like a overweight middle-aged fisherman. And the answer is, I got this shirt on sale at the Sportsman's Warehouse. But we are also doing top five best summer sipping whiskeys. Say that five times fast. So, Your Drinking Buddy, it's a great channel. Check it out. I'll put a link to his channel below. You know, he challenged the YouTube community. Let's see your top five summer sippers. And he had three rules. Rule number one, had to be low proof, 100 proof or lower. Rule number two, had to be low rye. And rule number three was, it had to be findable. So let's keep those rules in mind as we go through this. But my number one summer sipping whiskey is right behind me right here. And it breaks two of the three rules. This is a Jack Daniel's Coy Hill High Proof. Coming in at 144.2 proof, and it's not easily findable. And the reason that's a number one sipping whiskey is a simple fact that if you're going to go outside and get heat stroke, might as well start the process inside the house. All right, bottle number one. There it is. Jack Daniel's Bonded, a relatively new release, but it's kind of widely available, and it's cheap. I did a review on this actually a week or so ago. I'll link it above. You can check it out if you want some detailed notes. But I mean, I'm a Jack Daniel's fan, and I could not include a Jack Daniel's product. But most of the Jack I love is high proof, so couldn't fit it in here. But this one fits the bill. It's cheap. It's findable. It's crushable. It's good. It's a summer sipper, like banana ice cream. That's what you get off this one. All right. Number two. There it is. Maker's Mark 46 in the new bottle, no less. And you might say, but why is this a summer sipper? Well, it's low proof. It's only, 90? It's only 94 proof. But it's a wheater. It's sweet. It's got that French oak profile. And, I mean, it's now a twist off. I feel like they've gone backwards a little bit with that simple fact. But let's, smells fruity. Got a good amount of that French oak in it. You can sip this easily over ice, in a cocktail, or neat. So it's a great summer sipper. And number four on the list. Number three. None other than Russell's Reserve 10-Year. I love me some Wild Turkey, as do a lot of people out there. My favorite's Rare Breed, but again, it's over 100 proof. Even though I do drink Rare Breed in the summer, I just can't help myself. But Russell's 10 delivers that nice, woody, oaky, you know, baking spice profile of Russell's that you've come to love and enjoy. Comes in at the 10 years, so you can get some age still. And it's only 90 proof. And these are about $39.99 in PA, but I think they're less. I've seen them for like $33 elsewhere. So again, findable, crushable, and low proof for the summer. So we have three solid choices up here so far. We got the Russell's, the Maker's Mark, and the Jack Daniel's. You know, three different distilleries. You know, we followed Your Drinking Buddy's rules. I mean, you know, we're going along with the whole flow here. But here we go. Number two on this list is going to break a couple rules. Here it is. Sagamore Spirits Double Oak Rye. So it is not a low rye. It is below 100 proof, though. This is only, what's it even saying here? It's only 96.6 proof. So it's below 100 proof. However, she's 100% a rye, baby. I'm not sure the actual mash bill on this, but it's over 51% rye, which is not not low. Findability is okay. I don't know that you can find this in every store, but it can be found. It's just those... Gosh, it's so jammy. It's like a berry jam with that oak, and it's just very fruity. Probably would also make a good winter whiskey, however, because of the high fruitiness to it, I put it in here as a summer sipper. Sorry, had to break the rules. Now, our number one summer sipper. Get yourself some George Dickel Bottled in Bond. This happens to be the 2021 release, coming in at 100 proof. And the reason you might say it was, why is that a summer sipper? Because it's delicious. It's got that vitamin note, that orange note that we all come to love. It's not super heavy, doesn't burn. It's just, it's a delicious roller coaster of citrus and oak. It's a great summer sipper. Depending on what state you're in, I've seen these in quite a few places. Surprisingly, I've even seen previous year's releases. Again, this is a 2021. I've seen 2019 and 2020 on the shelf at some stores. Usually around $45 to $60, so not terribly expensive, but you're getting, this is a 13-year-old bottled in bond right here. So, hell of a value, and it's a good summer sipper. There you go. There's my top five summer sippers. Now, wouldn't be Bourbon Bill's channel if we didn't go a little overboard. So I do have my top one. It's poured right here in this glass. Why don't you take a look at that? Just a little red in color. I'm gonna give you just a few tasting notes, see if you can guess what it is. Oh, sweet heavens, it's oak, dark cherries and fruits, dark citrus, prunes, dates, all kinds of red, delicious fruits on here. Let's take a sip. Gives me the goosebumps in this fishing shirt here. How good that is. It's a delicious mix of red fruit and oak. Not real proofy. Almost tastes finished. There's your hint. My actual number one bottle, and you know, number six on the list, but my number one bottle, Bardstown The Bourbon Company, The Prisoner, finished in French oak red wine casks. So this is a 10-year-old Dickel, which already has the citrus and that orange zest note. Finished for, I believe it's like 2 or 3 years. Let me see here. A year and a half, sorry. Finished for another year and a half in Prisoner French oak red wine casks. Talk about fruity and a little like refreshing wine taste to it. This is delicious. Now, it couldn't really be considered one of the top five because A, it's hard to get and it's expensive. I believe this was like 130-ish, somewhere in there. They have released it multiple years. I'm not sure it's come out yet in 2022. But if you enjoy a nice red wine finished bourbon, this is a top-notch one and something I reach for quite a bit in the summer because it is so easy drinking. So if you like what you saw tonight, please like, comment, and subscribe. That's the most important. Stay tuned for more. Have a great evening, everybody.